The particle equation of motion is a mathematical model which describes the movement of a particle in a particle laden flow. It essentially relies on the application of Newton's second law to the particle, that is, particle mass times particle acceleration equal to the forces exerted on the particle. The left-hand side of the equation can be written as mp times dv divided by dt. The right-hand side comprises three main groups of forces, namely mass forces, Fm, forces exerted by the fluid on the particle, F from F to P, and forces exerted from the other particles on the current particles, F from P to P. Note that we have already encountered an application of this equation when we defined the particle response time. However, in that occasion, we refer to a very special formulation of the equation, in which, first, just one fluid particle force was considered, namely the drag. Second, the flow was 1D, and so the vectors were replaced by scalars. Let us now analyze the different forces in detail. In most engineering applications involving particle-laden flows, or at least in those of interest in the present course, the only relevant mass force is the gravitational force, which is equal to the product of mp and the gravitational acceleration g. As it is well known, this force causes the particle to fall down towards the bottom of the system. Among the different forces exerted on a particle by the surrounding fluid, the drag plays the dominant role in most particle-laden flows. As already seen, the drag force can be expressed as 1/2 times the density of the fluid rho f times the drag coefficient cd times the area of the particle cross-section p times dp to the square divided by 4 times the absolute value of the relative fluid particle velocity times the relative fluid particle velocity. Note that here, for the sake of generality, the velocities are vectorial quantities and the fluid velocity is indicated as u at p. This is the so-called unhindered fluid velocity, that is, the fluid velocity that can be hypothetically extrapolated to the particle centroid while ignoring disturbances caused by the particle itself. The drag coefficient is primarily a function of the particle Reynolds number, ρp, which is defined in terms of the particle diameter dp, the absolute value of the relative fluid particle velocity, the fluid density ρf, and the fluid viscosity μf. When ρp tends to zero, Stokes' flow occurs and, as already seen, cd is equal to 24 divided by ρp. However, complex phenomena take place at higher particle Reynolds number. Without entering into the details, vortical structures create behind the particle, and if the particle Reynolds number is sufficiently high, they result in the presence of an oscillating wake. The configuration of the flow has a direct effect on the drag coefficient, which first tends to become stable on average, and equal to about 0.44. And after a sudden drop at particle Reynolds number between 10 to the 5th power and 10 to the 6th power, it increases slowly. In most particle-laden flows of interest in this course, the particle Reynolds numbers are far below the condition of sudden drop. The formula of Schiller and Naumann is widely used to quantify the dependence of the drag coefficient upon the particle Reynolds number, up to particle Reynolds number of about 10 to the 5th power. It says that cd is equal to the maximum of two terms. The former is 24 divided by ρp times 1 plus 0.15 times ρp elevated to 0.687. The latter is 0.44. The drag coefficient curve shown and the Schiller and Naumann formula apply to spherical particles. However, in most cases, the particles encountered in the engineering applications are non-spherical. As already discussed, the shape of the particles is very difficult to characterize, and a rough indication can be obtained by referring to the particle spherical coefficient, phi, defined as the ratio between the surface area of the volume equivalent sphere and the actual surface area of the particle. It has already been mentioned that phi is equal to 1 for perfect spheres, whereas 0.66, 0.76 and 0.86 are the characteristic values for natural materials with sharp grains, nearly rounded grains and fully rounded grains, respectively. The formula by Heider and Levenspiel can be regarded as a generalization of the Schiller and Naumann formula for non-spherical particles up to a particle Reynolds number of about 10 to the 4th power. It says that the drag coefficient is equal to 24 divided by ρp times 1 plus a star times ρp elevated to power b star plus c star divided by 1 plus d star divided by ρp, where a star, b star, c star and d star are a function of the particle sphericity. When phi is equal to 1, the Heider and Levenspiel formula reduces to the Schiller and Naumann formula. For lower phi, it indicates higher CD, especially when the particle Reynolds number is high. Other fluid particle forces include the buoyancy force, Fb, which is due to the hydrostatic pressure over the particle surface, and it is equal to minus the density of the fluid, ρf, times the volume of the particle, Wp, times the gravitational acceleration, g. Typically, gravity and buoyancy are grouped together, yielding ρp minus ρf times Wp times g. The pressure gradient force, Fpr, which is due to the non-hydrostatic pressure over the particle surface, and it is equal to minus Wp times the non-hydrostatic pressure gradient. The virtual mass force, Fvm, whose basic idea is that, in order to accelerate the particle, also the fluid surrounding the particle has to be accelerated. The expression for Fvm is Cvm times ρf times Wp times dv over dt minus du at p over dt, where Cvm is a virtual mass coefficient, usually taken as 0.5. Note that these are not all possible fluid particle forces. Other types of forces exist, but in most cases they are very small and they will not be discussed here. These include, for instance, the history force, the shear lift and the rotational lift. All the forces discussed so far are potentially important in all coupling regimes. However, in the case of four-way coupling, also the forces exerted on a particle by the surrounding ones become important. The particle-particle interactions might occur either in the form of quick collisions or in the form of prolonged contacts. In the first case, they can be described by a number of models available in the literature. One of the most widely used is called soft sphere model, according to which the collision is represented by a combination of two spring dashpot systems and a friction slider. Finally, the quick collision between a particle and a solid wall is usually modeled via two restitution coefficients relating the particle velocity after and before the impact. The normal restitution coefficient, En, is the ratio between the normal particle velocity after and before the impact. The tangential restitution coefficient, Et, is the analogous parameter for the parallel velocity. A number of models have been proposed to estimate the restitution coefficients. One of the most widely used is that of Forder and co-workers, which relates En and dt to the particle impact angle referred to as theta p imp, which is the angle formed by the particle velocity at the stage of impingement and the surface. According to Forder model, the tangential restitution coefficient is rather minorly affected by theta p imp, whereas the normal restitution coefficient strongly decreases with increasing theta p imp, reaching the minimum value for normal impingement.